Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'll explain how easy it is to add the Syncfusion Blazor icon component to a Blazor WebAssembly application. I'll show you the different sizes of icons and their customization and how to display icon tooltips. Let me start with the application creation process. A Blazor application can be created using Visual Studio 2019, Visual Studio Code, or JetBrains Writer. In this video, I'll show you how to create a Blazor WebAssembly application using Visual Studio 2019. Make sure that you have installed it along with .NET Core SDK 3.1.8 or .NET 5.0 SDK. .NET Core SDK 3.1.8 requires Visual Studio 2019 version 16.7 or later, whereas .NET 5.0 requires Visual Studio 2019 version 16.8 or later. I'll open Visual Studio 2019 and choose Create a New Project from the dashboard. Then, choose the Blazor WebAssembly app and click the Next button. I will name my project and click Next. Then select the target framework, .NET Core 5.0, and click the Create button. The project has been created and is ready for use. Now, I will show you the step-by-step process for adding the icon component to this project. First, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor Buttons package to work with the Syncfusion icon component. To do that, I'll open the NuGet Package Manager, search for the button package, and install it in my application. Once it is installed, you can see the package added to this application's packages folder. Navigate to the _imports.razor page and import the syncfusion.blazor.buttons namespace. Then I need to register for the Syncfusion Blazor services. In the program.cs file, import the syncfusion.blazor namespace and register the Syncfusion Blazor service using the @syncfusionblazor method. I also need to register the license using the syncfusion.licensing.syncfusionlicenseprovider.registerLicense method to avoid the license validation message. Next, navigate to the index.html page within the root folder and add a Syncfusion Bootstrap 5 CSS reference from the installed package. If you want to know more about the Blazor WebAssembly app and how to add Syncfusion components to it, you can check out the video linked in the card above. The configuration steps are done, so let's move on to adding the Blazor icons component. Open the index.razor page and add the SF icon tag. Then add a predefined icon's name using the name property. Here I give the icon name as cut. Let me run the application. See, the cut icon is rendered. You can also set predefined sizes for Blazor icons, such as small, medium, and large. To explain this, I will add two more icons, copy and paste. Here I set predefined sizes, using the size property. For the cut icon, I specify the size as small, for the copy icon, medium, and large for the paste icon. See now, cut, copy, and paste are rendered with different sizes, starting from small to large. For the small size icon, font size is set to 8 pixels, the medium is the default size with 16 pixels, and the large icon font size is set to 24 pixels. To add tooltips to these icons, I just use the title property and give the tooltip value. For this icon, I add the title property and set its value to cut. See here, when I hover over the cut icon, its name will be shown in the tooltip. You can also customize the icon's appearance by overriding the eIcons class. eIcons class contains font family and common properties of font icons. To demonstrate this example, I will remove the size property. In the style element, I will override the eIcons class color and font size with custom values. Check now, the color and size of the icon are changed. I can also add third-party icons to the Syncfusion icon component using the icon CSS property. Here I add another SF icon tag and include the open iconic icons using the icon CSS property. Then I assign the value as rich. Under the index.html page, include the open iconic CSS reference. See here, the third-party icon is rendered using our Blazor Icons component. You can also add HTML attributes to the icon element using the add attributes directive. Let's see how to do that now. In the @code directive, define a custom attribute variable with a dictionary of the key pair value types. Then assign the style color as red. In the SF icon tag for copy icon, add the add attributes and assign the custom attribute variable. I will also comment out the icon related customization. You can see now, the copy icon color is customized. Finally, I'll show you how to integrate icons into button components. Icons and buttons are in the same package. So, I can directly use the SF button tag. Then specify the predefined icon name using the icon CSS property. Set the e-play icon. Set the content to play CSS class property to e-flat and enable the isPrimary property. To display the icon at the right side of the button content, add the icon position property and set its value to right. To know more details about button settings, check the documentation attached to the description below. As you can see, the flat button is rendered with the play icon and icon positioned at the right side of the button text. To render icons directly on HTML elements, include span element, add the class property, and assign the search icon. Check now, the Syncfusion search icon is rendered. Now, let me quickly summarize what we have seen so far. I have shown you how to create a Blazor WebAssembly app and add the Syncfusion icon component to it. Then I showed you the different sizes of icons and their customization and how to display icon tooltips. The complete pack of Syncfusion Blazor icons is listed in the user guide provided in the description below. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.